We all want to produce better parts with fewer rejects and less downtime. In episode 12, Blue showed you how tracking profile and surface finish can help you identify what's pushing your parts out of spec. Today, we're talking about surface finish with a helpful calculation that holds the secrets to optimizing your part quality.
Welcome to The Grinding Chronicles, presented by CDT Application Engineer, who we call Optimum Prime, also known as Harrison Sheldon.
Hi, I'm Harrison Sheldon, Application Engineer at CDT. As you may recall, surface finish, or RA, is the micro-level texture of your part. It's the tiny peaks and valleys you can't see with the naked eye. A practical way to visualize this is with an analogy of chip thickness. Every time your grinding wheel removes material, a tiny chip, it leaves behind a microscopic valley. The smaller the chip, the smoother the finish. We call this measurement average chip thickness, or ACT, and there's a formula developed by Dr. Richard Lindsay that lets you calculate it from your grinding parameters. Now, I get it. This equation might seem intimidating at first glance, but stay with me. We'll break it down step by step. In the top half, the numerator, you'll see grain diameter, represented by lowercase d, and specific material removal rate, or Q prime. In the denominator, there are several important variables: your workpiece speed, V sub W, the equivalent wheel diameter, D sub E, the wheel speed, V sub S, and abrasive concentration, simply noted as F. Once you've calculated ACT, there are two simple equations you can use to predict your surface finish RA number. For very fine finishes between 1 and 10 micro inches, your RA is equal to 6 times ACT raised to the 0.3 power. For finishes in the 10 to 100 micro inch range, RA equals 2.2 times ACT raised to the 0.72 power. These equations show the values for calculations in inches. For metric values, please visit our webpage at cdtusa.net/thegrindingchronicles. Now, here's the really useful part. Even if you're not running these numbers constantly, understanding this equation immediately tells you which machine parameters will give you the best results. Look closely at the exponents. Notice wheel speed, V sub S, is raised to a high power in the denominator, so it has the potential to make a significant impact. This means increasing your wheel speed should lower ACT and improve your surface finish. On the other hand, work rotational velocity has a small power, so changing this parameter will not significantly impact your results. Understanding the relationship between these variables takes the guesswork out of your adjustments. Instead of randomly changing settings, you'll know exactly which parameters have the biggest impact. Of course, keep in mind, real-world factors like coolant contamination, machine vibrations, or wheel runout still matter. If your results aren't lining up with the predictions, these external factors could be at play. By tracking your profile and finish, and using this simple calculation, you have powerful tools to optimize your grinding operation, reduce scrap, and maximize parts per dress. And remember, if you need assistance running these numbers or exploring solutions, just reach out to us at thegrindingchronicles@cdtusa.net. We're always here to help you grind better parts.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like, follow, and subscribe button, and get ready to learn something new in another episode from Continental Diamond Tools.